This is the Gaumont British News, presenting the truth to the free peoples of the world. Stepping stones between the Commonwealth and Malaya. These islands are among the richest prizes for which Japan struck in the Pacific. The name of Java means rice country, but Dutch colonization has given her East Indies infinitely more. Beneath the solemn magnificence of a Buddhist temple, there dwells a people whose ancient culture has survived the change to modern needs. But a race whose forefathers were engaged in piracy and plunder became, under the influence of Holland, contented, prosperous, and peaceful. Of the total population of some 70 millions, 65 millions were native to the islands, 1.5 million were Chinese, and approximately 300,000 Dutch. The fact that they could live in harmony together is a tribute to the wise administration of the Netherlands government. Yes, Java was a happy land, but her wealth was too great a temptation for the Nazis of Asia. Further evidence of the development of the Netherlands East Indies, a typical washing day seen in Batavia canals, goes side by side with a busy scene in the harbor. And in the towns, there were fine modern buildings vying with beautiful examples of old Dutch architecture. This was the recent opening of Parliament, performed by the Governor General representing Queen Wilhelmina. The motto of the House of Orange is, I will maintain. And when in Europe Holland was overrun by Hitler, this government never wavered. This country now has been overrun by the enemy in the Pacific. With its great wealth of rubber and sugar and tea and tapioca and all kinds of spices. No use trying to pretend that this is not another heavy blow to the Allied cause. But this is the testing time for all of us, and we never expected the greatest war to be won without suffering heavy reverses. We want to give it out as well as take it, but this is the time to prove that we can hang on through every kind of disaster, not just the kind that we have survived in the past, but also those of the present and the future. If we can do that, we can turn the tide. When Holland crashed in Europe, more than 1 million tons of shipping was saved and sent to the Indies. Some of that has been lost since, but the rest is still continuing the fight. The oil wells, which were Java's greatest source of wealth, have now been lost to us. And though scorched earth has saved them from the Japanese, now more than ever is there need to save petrol. 1942 ranks in tragedy almost with 1940. But we came through 1940 with 1940 grimness, and we shall come through this year, too. It was oil that Japan chiefly had in mind when the trade delegate went from Tokyo to Java. On the right of the Japanese delegate in civilian clothes is Dr. Van Mook. As Minister for Economic Affairs, he refused Japan the oil she needed. Sabotage has seen that Japan will still be denied Dutch oil. These, then, were the islands which acted as a magnet to the greedy little men of Nippon. And with the fall of Singapore, they advanced swiftly upon Java and Sumatra. The people of the Dutch East Indies faced war with the example of Europe before them. ARP was organized with the memory of Rotterdam to remind them of the scale on which air attack might be expected. Efficient fire services organized and shelters built. Landing grounds were made unusable by stakes and obstructions. But here again, the tragedy of insufficient air defenses turned the scale. Japan had virtual control of the Java skies. Craftsmen of the islands had turned from their peacetime trades to make munitions. Silversmiths became workers in steel as the factories made bombs and shells. But the efforts of a nation which only wanted peace could not withstand the onslaught of the aggressors who for years had thought and worked only for war. Look at these things we have lost. Look, not with despair, but with renewed determination. ¶¶ commanding the Dutch Air Force in Java was General Van Eyen, but the forces at his disposal were hopelessly outnumbered. Japan had also organized a tremendous system of espionage. The enemy seemed to know exactly when the defenders' planes were grounded. They attacked them with incredible accuracy and fierceness while they were thus unable to reply. And so the small air force that might have staved off defeat was quickly destroyed. But above all, there was the shortage of fighters. Commanding the Netherlands Navy was Vice Admiral Helfrich, who was recently appointed to the command of all Allied navies in this area. The Royal Netherlands Navy went into action with matchless gallantry in defense of Java. In the finest tradition of the sea, her cruisers and destroyers never hesitated to attack, no matter how heavy the odds. With the surface craft, were submarines taking heavy toll of Japanese warships and transport. But Japan came fresh to the war of the sea. Her merchant fleet is large, and for the present, losses do nothing to stem her advance. For the time, Japan's fleet is unchallengeable in the Western Pacific. Only by self-denial at home and by the most gigantic efforts in our shipyards can we hope to meet that challenge, but it must and will be met. What of the army? For the destiny of Australia is closely bound with that of Java, and the Dutch islands bring Japan within striking distance of the shores of the great Commonwealth. These pictures of the army and navy and air force in Java are at first sight puzzling. Why were they defeated? The Netherlands East Indies Army peacetime strength with 125,000 men. Japan has overrun Java as she ran through Malaya. What is the answer to this sore question? There were planes and tanks and ships, and yet Japan came on in almost unbroken success. The answer is that it was not enough. We in the democracies are still thinking of war in terms of peace. Since 1918, we had grown to believe that war was unthinkable. An army was only a necessary sideline to a nation. But with the Axis, an army is the nation. Everyone is mustered and regimented to make up a nation ready for war. Fighting is the business of every citizen. And we shall never finish off this war until we too can bring ourselves to feel like that. How shall we avenge the loss of Java and keep ourselves from a like fate? This is the time to make a vow. That the last words from Java's radio shall not be ours. Now we shut down. Long live our Queen. Goodbye, till better times.